So I want to create a VDM map, a vector displacement map of this sculpt that I've already created. And vector displacement maps are similar to displacement maps. The one big exception is that we can use vector displacement maps to create undercuts. So I can have a three-dimensional surface like this hook that hooks over itself, and a regular displacement map couldn't render that. But a vector displacement map will be able to render that. So I'm going to rip this to a VDM, and then I'll be able to use this as a tile, a high-res tile with lizard skin and the spike to tile on top of other characters to create lizard characters, etc. Now, at this point, I could extract a vector displacement map from the low-res part of this object from the high-res, and it would work. But it won't give us the results that we want. It won't be able to, you won't be able to use it on any other surfaces, because if we think about what the level zero surface looks like on this spike, it looks like the spike itself. So we need to start our displacement from scratch. We're going to start from a brand new plane, and I'm just going to create a new plane in Mudbox, just the basic plane geometry. And this plane geometry, this level zero plane here, is a perfectly flat surface, and I can project my high-res sculpt onto this and create the detail that I need. So I'll add the low-res plane to the target, and I'll add my high-res sculpt to the source. I'll extract it, and I want to extract to a 32-bit file format like TIFF, and I'll extract that out. And we'll create a vector displacement map that I can use to displace other objects. Now let's test this. I'm going to subdivide my low-res plane so it has plenty of geometry, and I'll import that new displacement map into my stencils, and we'll see that it pops up in the bottom corner there. And I'll look at my object from above, and I'll just project the stencil from above, so we're looking basically flat at it. And this is the easiest way to use it. It's also not very interesting, but it's a great test to see if our VDM works. So I'll turn on my sculpt tool. I want to have full 100% strength, and I want to have 100 buildup, otherwise we won't get the results we're looking for. And when we paint over it, we should see the sculpt that we created pop out of the surface, including that hook behind it, that curvature that creates that undercut. We wouldn't be able to represent that using a standard displacement map. So let's look at something a little bit more interesting. I'll use the Mudbox base mesh, and this time I'm going to use the repeat tool with a strength of 100 and a buildup of 100, and I'm going to sculpt across it using my stylus so that I have pressure sensitivity to control the size of the spike as it's extruded from the mesh's body. And our mesh will need to be fairly high res. We can adjust the stamp spacing like I just did a moment ago to control the placement, to move the spikes or whatever it is farther away from each other in this case, or we could also move them closer to each other. And so now we have this really detailed vector displacement map that we can use to add detail to other sculpts that we're working on.